Hello, welcome back to my channel and welcome to my 2024 reading goals and my January TBR video. So it's been a while since I posted a video. What do I need to update you on? I've read 71 books last year and I didn't get that many books for Christmas or in the Waterstone sale. She says, despite the fact she got 6 books at Christmas and 7 in Waterstone sale, but that's not that many for me. I didn't really vlog just because I wasn't in the mood to vlog, and I have done no end of year content because I'll be honest, I didn't do a reading journal last year and I regret it. So the reading journal is back. I don't know if I will be doing a video on like my setup because it's pretty basic, but I do like the colours. I'll have a think. So I thought instead of doing a 2024 goals video and then a January TBR video, just showing them all together. You may notice we have something in the background. If you watch my vlogs, you know, we'll have known that I've become obsessed with Stray Kids recently. And my second secret, not secret, Santa at work gifted me Chan in a frame. So he's now the protector of the red books each month. So expect to see a lot of this man. Well, this frame. Anyway, let's not go into my obsession with Stray Kids and all things cream. So, goals for 2024. Reading wise, I am not upping my goal of 60 books this year. I read 71 last year, but I think 60 is a nice even number because I can read 5 books a month, which is doable in my eyes. Second goal, don't haul more books than you've read. My entire thing last year was to not have as many books on my to be read shelves at the end of the year as at the start. I was down by 1 book. So I hauled the exact same amount as read and unhauled, which isn't good for me. So at the moment I have 62 books, I think, on my current to be read shelf on Goodreads. I want that to be in the 50s at least by the end of 2024. As you may have noticed, all my series, like books and series, have been put on this top shelf. I want to get at least 4 series or trilogies either caught up on or completed in 2024. I think I did this really well in 2023, but because I didn't have a tracker anywhere, like a journal, I lost count. I know people have spreadsheets. I forget about spreadsheets. So I think by doing like a little series tracker spreadsheet here definitely will help me. I currently have 171 books on my wish list on Goodreads. And another goal that's like slightly lower on the list is to get that under 171. I know I will add books on there, but this means that if I do buy books at pre-orders, I want them to be on my wish list rather than just mood buying, which I know is a lot of fun, but I need to get that number down. I did go through that list before Christmas and I got it from like 180 something to 179, and then I got books. So then was that right about it? It was definitely like the 180, 190. So I've been working on it. I just need to make a more conscious effort on working on it. And then my final reading goal, I will get you the book. So my last reading goal is to start and finish the complete Sherlock Holmes by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. I'm not planning on reading this in a month. This would be my whole month book. But I think there are 7 or 8 stories in here. 1, 2, 3. 8. I was right. 8 books in here. 8 books. Well, yeah. Book/stories in here. So I kind of want to get these read by the end of this year. I got this lovely edition from my friend Sophie. She wasn't hauling it. So it's been sat on my shelves looking pretty up there. But I think I need to get it read. So this is the year reading goal. The only goal I have really is to be more selective with readathons this year. I know I cut down them last year. That was so good for me. But I was still going into the ones I did pick going, I'm going to read all these books. And it wouldn't happen. I don't think I completed a lot of readathons last year. So this year I only have 1 more readathon, and that is Buzzwordathon. I kind of have a TBR Buzzwordathon, but I'm just going to take it month by month as to what book I read. Just because if things change or I know I want to read that book, I don't feel pressured into having to read it or feeling down because I haven't read it. So now that's out of the way, onto the January TBR. And of course we will start with the first story in this big book. And that is A Study in Scarlet. So that is 140-ish pages. So doable, but I will just have this on here and obviously not just a, yeah. Book number two is for Buzzwordathon for January, and that prompt is there, or there. Your pick. So I have gone with Castles in Their Bones by Laura Sebastian. I will not get rid of this sticker because it is signed. Never trust a pretty face. Empress Margot has had plans for her daughter since the day they were born. Princesses Sophronia, Daphne and Beatrice will be queens. And now, age 16, they each must leave their homeland and marry their princes. Beautiful, smart and demure, the triplets appear to be the perfect brides because Margot knows that everyone underestimates a girl. But trained from birth in the arts of deception, seduction and violence, with a singular goal to bring down monarchies, the princesses and no innocence. And their marriages are merely the first stage of their mother's grand vision to reign over the entire continent. The princesses have spent their lives preparing, and now they are ready, each with her own secret skill and each with a single wish pulled from the stars. Only the stars have their own plans, and their mother hasn't told them all of hers. And book number three, and a book I should have read last year to end a trilogy, is The Bone Shard War by Andrea Stewart, book number three in The Drowning Empire, which means I cannot tell you anything what is in this synopsis because it will spoil books one and two. All I will say is The Bone Shard Daughter was, it hit me right for a high fantasy, and I have loved this trilogy since. Book number two was a 3-star compared to the first one, which was a 5-star, but I find that with trilogies, the middle books tend to be the weak ones, in my opinion. Really looking forward to finishing this trilogy. As you'll probably notice, I'm not really reading that many high fantasy, and this is one trilogy that I knew I was going to finish because I enjoyed it so much. Book number three, which I realised I've just said for Bone Shard War, but technically this is book number three, is Throne of the Fallen by Kerry Maniscalco. This is a side book to the Kingdom of the Wicked. It's like a side, yeah, it's like a separate series, but it includes characters that we've been introduced in that series, but you don't need to read that series to read this book. It's a standalone, but can be part of it. You get what I mean. The Prince of Envy has never claimed to be a saint, but when a cryptic note arrives at his demon court, signalling the beginning of a deadly game, he knows it will take more than a hint of sin to win. Riddles, hexed objects, anonymous players, nothing will stand in his way. Camilla is an artist with troubles of her own. A desperate mistake has landed her in debt to a notorious rake. Threatened with ruinous scandal, she is forced to enter a devil's bargain with Envy. A bargain that reveals secrets and ignites passions that neither of them expects. Together, Envy and Camilla must embark on a perilous journey through the underworld, from glittering demon courts to the sultry vampire realm and beyond, while trying to avoid the most dangerous trap of all, falling in love. Book number four is Find You First by Linwood Barclay. This has been on many a TBR, but I will still read you the synopsis because I've forgotten half of it. Tech billionaire Miles has more money than he can ever spend, but he can't buy more time. Diagnosed with a terminal illness, he is forced to take a long, hard look at his past. Somewhere out there, Miles has children who don't know it, but they might be about to inherit the good and bad from him. Possibly his fortune, or possibly something more sinister. So Miles decides to track them down, but a lethal killer is one step ahead of him. One by one, people are vanishing. Not just disappearing, every trace of them is wiped. And the fifth and final book is Infamous by Lex Croucher. I know there is a buy one get one half price sticker, but I take them off as I read the books. 22-year-old aspiring writer Edith Eddy Miller and her best friend Rose have always done everything together. Climbing trees, throwing grapes at boys, sneaking bottles of wine, practicing kissing. Now that they're out in society, Rose is suddenly talking about marriage, and Eddie is horrified. When Eddie meets charming, renowned poet and rival to Lord Byron, Nash Nicholson, he invites her to his crumbling Gothic estate in the countryside. The entourage of eccentric artists indulging in pure hedonism is exactly what Eddie thinks she needs in order to finish her novel and make a name for herself. But Eddie might discover that trying to keep up with her literature heroes isn't all poems and pleasure. So that is a TBR for the start of 2024. Doable for me, I hope. I'm keeping it short and simple. If I don't want to read a book, I'm not going to read a book. I'll swap if I want to swap. If I don't want to read five books or five and a bit, I'm not going to read five and a bit books. But saying that, have you read any of these books? Is there anyone here where you're like, Michelle, I definitely think you won't like it. Or Michelle, why have you not read this so far? Let me know, please. I'm always looking forward to hearing what you guys have to say. But if you liked this video, please give it a like. If you are new to my channel, hi, my name is Michelle. My reading, like my life, is a chaotic mess. And I'm trying to get through it one book at a time. Links for my Goodreads and Bookstagram, I want to say Booktwitter, but I've actually got rid of that now, are down below if you want to follow me on there. If you don't want to follow, no pressure. But until the next video, bye.